Long conversations with anti-aging experts and biochemists at the Silicon Valley Health Institute, SVHI, combined with my own research in biohacking, revealed some basic principles that were counterintuitive and flipped what I thought I knew about dieting on its head. As a leader of SVHI, I had the chance to learn from a bevy of medical and nutrition experts who taught me that nutrition is far more complex than just counting calories. They showed me that our simple models for thinking about food don't work, no matter how much we want them to or how easy they are to talk about. Despite what I saw everywhere in the press, eating more of the right fats and calories seemed to be the secret to gaining shocking amounts of power and energy, feeling awesome, getting my brain back online, and losing weight so easily that it almost felt accidental. As I dug deeper to find out which sources of fats and calories would give me the absolute best, most consistent results, the Bulletproof Diet began to take shape. I discovered that fat isn't good or bad. Protein isn't good or bad. Even carbs aren't good or bad. Food and macronutrients are more complex than that, but the hacks I developed will make it seem simple. Fantastic fats. Fat is the most important and least inflammatory macronutrient, and on the Bulletproof Diet, 50 to 70% of your daily calories should come from the right kinds of fats. This is not a license to eat whatever kinds of fat you find. There are some bad fats that really will make you fat, but eating significant amounts of the right types of fat will not. In fact, when you eat more healthy fats, your body becomes better equipped to naturally turn it into energy. We're often told to avoid fat because it has more calories. But when we build a high-performance car to go faster, we design it to use high-octane fuel, which stores more energy per gallon than low-octane fuel. We measure the octane of food using calories, and when you teach your body to burn fat for energy, it becomes a higher-performance machine, complete with a kind of energy that's normally unavailable. Our cells, organs, and brains are all made of fat and need high-quality fat to function optimally. Fat is also the basis for the lining of your nerves, called myelin, which allows electricity to flow efficiently. When you have more myelin, you literally think faster. When people hear that they should eat more fat, they often start to worry about cholesterol. But cholesterol is so vital that your liver manufactures it according to your body's needs. Cholesterol isn't necessarily an enemy. Even if you manage to consume no cholesterol through your diet, your body would still produce the amount of cholesterol it requires for many basic functions. Fat-containing cholesterol helps build the outer coating of your cells, makes up the bile acids that you need to digest foods in your intestines, and provides the building blocks for your hormones and vitamin D. When you eat enough of the right fats without excess carbs, your body learns to efficiently burn fat for fuel and to form healthy cell membranes. This is because your body burns carbs first. On average, men should aim for at least 120 to 150 grams of fat, 8 to 10 tablespoons per day. Women should aim for at least 90 to 120 grams, 6 to 8 tablespoons per day. Although your body weight, activity level, genetics, and hunger all play roles in determining the exact right amount for you. That's why I recommend that healthy fats make up a range between 50 and 70% of the calories you eat each day. So what are the right kinds of fat? Nutritionist and early trans fats researcher Mary Enig, Ph.D., has long been a proponent of a diet high in healthy fats. She developed two basic ways to understand fats. The first is to look at how long a fat molecule is. As a general rule for edible fats, the shorter the fat, the rarer and more anti-inflammatory it is. This is why the Bulletproof Diet ensures that you get adequate amounts of the harder-to-find short- and medium-chain fats, which include the butyric acid found in butter and several types of medium-chain triglycerides found in coconut oil.